Welcome to Rely Local Frederick Business Radio Spotlight. For the next 30 minutes, you will hear fast-paced interviews, unique perspectives, and valuable insight from real people who believe that empowering local business is everybody's business. This show is about the backbone of America, small businesses right here in and around the communities where we live, work, and play. And now, your host, Caressa Flannery, brings you Rely Local Frederick's Business Radio Spotlight.
Hello, hello. This is Caressa Flannery, your host for the Rely Local Business Spotlight. And I'm sure a lot of you out there are wondering, what is Rely Local? Well, Rely Local is actually a grassroots campaign to help support the local businesses in Frederick County. Simply put, a healthy community depends on a healthy economy, and both completely depend on the local businesses in Frederick. Simply put, more money spent with local businesses stays here, about 68%. Where much less money spent with national chains stays in the area, only about 14%. And money spent online, well, that simply leaves us forever. Now, it's not to say that we don't want you to spend money online or we don't want you to spend money with the bigger chains like Walmart or Target, but you want to make sure that you're spending a bit of your income with the local businesses. This helps support our economy and so many other things. And to us at Rely Local, supporting local businesses doesn't stop with the economy. It is all about creating a stable and vibrant community. Frederick businesses create jobs, like tax revenue for schools and parks and roads, while offering diversity in the marketplace with unique products and services that are not found in these big box stores or chain restaurants. Not to mention, these local businesses are owned by the very people who are sponsoring our little leagues, sponsoring events in the community, donating to local charities, and even volunteering for those community events. They're giving back to the community in countless ways. You rely on them, but can they rely on you? Every dollar that you spend with a Frederick business stimulates our local economy. You don't even have to break the piggy bank to support these local businesses. Just refocusing $20 of your current spending toward local businesses instead of online, national, or big box merchants can have a huge impact in our community. So that's a little bit about Rely Local, but we share all kinds of information about local businesses on our Facebook page. It's Rely Local Frederick MD, so definitely check us out there. But today we have with us some local folks who are real estate agents with Long & Foster. We have with us Sharon Bremer Potter and John Potter, who are actually a team through Long & Foster, and we are going to chat with them a little bit about real estate today. So guys, welcome. Welcome to the show.
Thanks for having us.
Yeah, and really excited to have you guys. So, you know, the first things first, we want to make sure that people understand who you guys are. You know, tell us a little bit about Sharon and John and, you know, how you got into real estate and, you know, what your passion is.
Sure. I've grown up in the Frederick area and got into real estate, just kind of fell into it, really. I started buying investment properties. I bought my first one and just started watching the real estate market, got really interested in it, decided to take a plunge and just give it a shot. And I bought a vacant property that I found kind of on my own, took out an equity line on my home and went ahead and purchased it.
Did you rehab it?
I did all the work.
Wow, that's awesome.
Hired people, did a lot of it myself, spent many hours there until midnight.
And you're not very old, so you must have been young when you did
that. I was in my 20s, I believe.
Wow.
I remember, late 20s.
Wow.
We fixed it up, ended up keeping it for 3 years and renting it, and then sold it thereafter, but made a very good profit on it. And, you know, from there
so
went
you got
on
the
to,
bug.
I got the bug. I got a feel for it, really enjoyed it, and then went on to buy several more properties after that. And still, I don't know, I found myself talking real estate all the time, although at the time I wasn't doing real estate, so went on to
Isn't
find out
the
that
way
that
passions w- usually
exactly.
are found, though?
You know? I was coaching other people and not doing it, decided it was a good idea to probably pursue, and took off from there, and I've loved it ever since. So,
you went and got, like, your real estate, like, you went, did the real estate school or something like
I
that?
I went to and school and got my license and just jumped right in and took off, and things have went well ever since
then. And how long ago was that?
That was in 2004.
Wow.
So since then, yes, it's been very, very successful career, and, you know, very rewarding to help people and teach them about what I went through. And I've helped many other people buy investment properties and taught them the whole process
been there,
that
done
I've
that
been
kind
exactly
of thing.
And went on to learn many other aspects of the business as well. But it's taken off really well, and it's been a lot of fun. And then
now, have you been with Long and Foster the entire time?
I have been with Long
and Foster.
So you hooked
up with them
the whole time
in the very beginning.
Been a great company to work for. So yeah, it's been great. And then John came on to join me 4 years ago, I believe it's been now too. And John might want to elaborate a little bit as well. Do you want to?
And John, you two just joined forces, a couple of years ago?
2008 is when we started together.
Okay.
Well, that's when I made a career change also, because I was originally from Montgomery County, so I moved up here in 87. Loved the area and the people and community.
And you used to be a car guy, right?
Yes.
Yes.
And that was my main business. Mm-hmm. I had that for 16 years here in the area and served a lot of clients and had a great reputation. And Sharon was doing so well in real estate, and I was like, wow, I really want a career change after all those years. So she got me into real estate, took the license test, and took the course with Long and Foster and loved it. And it's been a great learning experience. And
two heads are better than one.
Exactly. And we're both full time. So that helps. Yeah.
People get two agents for the price of one.
Yeah. Exactly.
Exactly.
And we both offer different aspects to, he's very good with home construction and with home inspections and things like that, and really pointing out things that others might miss. And, I have my, I'm an accredited buyer's representative too. So we've gone on to taking lots of classes as well as short sale certified, and we have lots of, we just educate ourselves all the time to try to better ourselves.
Yeah,
and
definitely. Well, you always got to keep up to date
what's going on
out there in the industry.
Things change so fast today. Yes, you have to stay up on the certifications and learn what they put out there so you can stay informative to help your clients. Because if you don't know what's going on, you're not going to be able to help them 100% like we do.
Right.
And
we
stay on top of that.
And it sounds like, with your the construction, aspects that you have, you can help people even after the sale, which
Absolutely.
Is great. So through the entire process, where people are freaking out because it's like the biggest purchase that they'll maybe make in their lives, you're able to kind of, take them through the process.
And we've assembled a really good team of contractors, service people that if our clients have a problem with their home, they can call us and we can direct them to somebody they can trust, like you trust us, to help them with a problem with their home.
Yeah, and that's great. Right. That's beyond the real estate.
It
you know
is.
What I mean?
Right.
Like
it
the
is.
Transaction itself.
It's very valuable. It is extremely valuable.
And I would assume
you can trust today.
Yeah, and I mean, I know you guys, so we're friends, obviously, and I know that the type of people you are. I imagine that so many people you sell houses to, you have become friends with.
Absolutely.
And you keep them.
Lifelong
And they might even get it, purchase investment properties through you.
Absolutely.
And, that's definitely, the referral type of thing, keeps you, because, if they're pleased with the service that you did, they'll tell other people, and that enhances your business.
Sure. Our business is largely referral-based, just from past clients, because we do go above and beyond, and we try to both participate with every client as a team and not just one of us. So that we give everybody everything that's both of us, because we both share so many different levels of knowledge, and it just helps.
We're married, so we do it 24/7.
Yeah.
There's always discussion in our house at any time.
Yeah.
Of what's going on. So
awesome.
We live in
real estate.
Well,
listen, we are already to the first break. How about that? So we're actually going to, head into a break here, but and we'll be right back with Sharon and John. But I want to remind everybody that we are on Facebook, WTHU. It's called the Source Radio Network. That's what you want to find when you go onto Facebook. And then also Rely Local Frederick also has a Facebook page. So definitely hook up with us, become a fan, and you'll learn all kinds of things about local businesses and things that they're doing. And you will learn more about WTHU and a lot of the different programming that they have as well. Okay? We will be right back.
And each town looks the same to me, the movies and the factories, and every stranger's face I see reminds me that I long to be homeward bound. I wish I was.
Home ownership is the American dream, and if you have dreamed of buying or selling your house, what better place to start than the Dream Team? Let John and Sharon Potter make your dreams come true. There is a reason why their buyers and sellers call them the Dream Team. With over 20 years of experience, John and Sharon Potter have an outstanding reputation for customer service and market knowledge. Check out their website, youramericandreamteam.com, today. John and Sharon Potter are proud sponsors of the Champion Frederick Keys and members of Rely Local Frederick.
A family to care for, a future to prepare for, assets to protect. With so many challenges to face every day, isn't it good to know there's one company prepared to help you meet them all? the Prudential Insurance Company of America, the place people turn to for the things that matter most. Call your local financial professional associate, Gail Gordon, at 301-547-4010 to help you with your insurance and financial needs. The number again is 301-547-4010. Call today. Insurance is issued by the Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates.
I'm sitting in the railway station, got a ticket for my destination.
Hello again. This is Caressa Flannery, the host of the Rely Local Business Spotlight, and we are here talking real estate today. We are here with two real estate agents from Long & Foster in Frederick, and they are actually a team. They are a married team, in fact, and they, you know, work with buyers and sellers. They just do, you know, amazing stuff, you know, take people through the process for one of their, probably their most, you know, the largest purchase that they'll ever make in their lives. We are here with Sharon Bremer Potter and John Potter, and they are telling us a little bit about, you know, their experiences with real estate. And we talked a little bit about how you got into real estate. So guys, now I want to talk a little bit about the services that you provide, because I know you work with both the sellers and the buyers. So let's, you know, yes, kind of go into, and Sharon, I know you're certified to deal mostly with the buyers. So why don't you talk to us a little bit about that?
Yeah, I mean, I have my ABR designation, so I am certified with to handle buyer transactions a little more extensively, but I've absolutely done both throughout mm-hmm. my career. So, but yeah, for, you know, first-time home buyers, relocation, I am relocation certified as well. There's, you know, most importantly is getting them to the right context so that the transaction goes smoothly, and mm-hmm. making sure they're with a great lender and that they know their financing terms, right, and everything is out in the open and they're aware 100% of what the process is all about. So that's mm-hmm. kind of what we're here to do, is make sure to walk them through step by step, put them in good hands. We have assembled a great team of lenders, home inspectors, mm-hmm. title companies, you name it. We have great people that we can direct people to use to make sure that the goal is that it's a good experience for them. Mm-hmm. So sure, they tell all their friends, and, you know, and I think all of our clients would gladly say that we have gone above and beyond, and that it's been smooth. And if anything comes up, because things do come up in today's market,
sure,
you know, yeah, issues do come up, and you have to be prepared to handle anything and have that experience that, if, you know, there's so many different scenarios that go on with a home purchase that can go on. Right. And I think it's important to have the right person behind you that's been there and been out there and done this millions of times or hundreds of times, and can, right, you know, is prepared to handle any situation that arises, so that takes the pressure off the buyer and, you know, the fear of anything going wrong. And John, you know, as well.
Yeah, and John, helps you, out with you that, want to, you know, speak to,
oh, on both sides, of course. Yeah. But yeah, list, sure. And then we list homes people for sale, and we go mm-hmm. into their house when they want to sell their property and mm-hmm. go and evaluate the condition of the home and try to get it accurately priced to be on the market so it moves. If that's their
absolutely.
Goal to sell their house, which it usually is, mm-hmm. to get it to sell quickly instead of having it sit because it's inaccurately priced. And then the other thing that we provide also is during that initial contact, we go in and evaluate their home. I do, to see if there's mm-hmm. any going to be any issues if we get a contract of where the repairs are needed. So we try to get the homeowner to repair them prior to that, so there's no issues when a buyer comes in, sees the house, mm-hmm. likes everything about it, gets the contract on it. If there's no issues on the inspections, the deal is done. They can
right.
move on. So
yeah, because I was going to ask you, you know, also, you know, what if somebody does decide to sell their home, you know, what all do they have to do to prep their home, you know, for the sale?
That's
right.
What I do.
So
I go in
there.
I go in there.
Look at everything.
Everything.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we both try to go and be present for listing appointments.
Yes,
and
we help stage the home, get the furniture moved around properly to make it
right.
flow for
mm-hmm.
a buyer
right.
to come in.
Yeah, just offer.
If they want to put money
sure
into
it's
a
clean.
House.
Absolutely. Yeah, we do.
Yeah,
we offer,
absolutely.
Give them a list of suggestions of things that they should do.
Exactly.
Right. You know.
Yeah. And hopefully they get it done. And that way it's right. really a seamless transaction.
Yeah,
at that
oftentimes
point.
We go yeah. back the first time and, you know, we've given them the list. We go back the second time and it's amazing.
Make
the
sure
transformation
good,
when they listen and they take your advice,
yeah.
the house sells.
And then it gets put on the market, and then, so I guess at that point then, you know, it's in the MLS
system. We advertise
it.
We have about 47 to 48 internet sites that mm-hmm. these homes go on through our
gotcha.
Long & Foster website also, and our own website.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a lot of exposure, tons
yes,
of exposure
right.
for their home. And then we get a lot of, you know, activity on most
yeah.
of our listings, and if everything's right,
with,
it usually
yeah,
goes, especially in
us,
today's market.
Yeah, with both of us being full-time too, that's, you know, we
right.
are on this every day, 7 days a week, right. making sure that we've covered all our bases and reviewing all our inventory and right. checking on all our buyers and just really being active and proactive yeah. with everything. Just, you know, their satisfaction is absolutely number one to making sure, sure that they're completely happy. Because, again, we are so largely referral-based that, you know, you've so got, that's, you know, it's got to prioritize and make sure everybody is yeah. taken care of, well taken care of.
Definitely. Now, do you, when you go into the home, do you have to make recommendations, you know, for things to be fixed? And then they have to sometimes spend money ahead of time to, you know, kind of get their home.
It depends.
You
know,
in order. I've been on so many home inspections for our buyers mm-hmm. that I am so aware of how all the inspectors that are out there mm-hmm. go through a home and look at it and what they evaluate that. That's what I do basically when I go right. out. I'm not certified to do that, but I've observed so intently that yeah. I make sure that
so you're able to help
I go
them.
Say, let's yeah. hey, let's go take care of this now so there's yeah. no issues when we come to a contract point right. because that's where it gets sticky sometimes.
Because it might and not go through.
Exactly. If, deals know, fail. And if you
the purchaser might, you know, say, right. well, I want that fixed or whatever.
Exactly. Yeah. And we exactly. try to yeah. prep them completely on that so it just flies mm-hmm. right through that part of it. Because right. that's usually the sticking point.
Right.
Yeah. As long as the buyer comes with good financing terms and we know it's a good lender. That part of it, our part is getting the house ready, and as long as the homeowner's cooperated and done it, it usually goes right through.
Great, great. Yep. Okay, well, you know, I know that, you know, the agreement of whether it's the best time to buy or sell is always debated, or it's consistently debated out there right now, you know, due to the economy and whatnot, but, so which is it? Which is it? Is it?
Both.
I think it's both.
It's both.
Yeah, I mean, I guess it's a debatable issue for some, but, I mean, the interest rates are historically low. It's a fantastic time as far as financing is concerned. The market is extremely busy, and I mean, we're dealing with multiple contracts on homes. Almost the past six or seven contracts I've written have had multiple offers on it, yeah. one up to 18.
It's a crazy market.
It's crazy. Yeah. So, I mean, so your odds of selling now versus, you know, a few years ago is definitely in your favor if you're priced correctly.
Right.
It's going to sell, which is huge, so which we haven't been able to say that in years. You usually would put a house on the market and hope that it would sell. Now I would say yeah. you're probably going to sell and probably have more than one offer.
Right. Now where it was so, months on the market or even
now
a
it's
year.
Days.
Because I know people have had a house on
Absolutely.
You know in the past have had houses on the market yeah. like a year.
Yes.
I'm like, really? That's
yeah.
kind of crazy.
Now it's days.
But now it's like days.
Days.
Yeah. Like houses are selling in like 4 days
insane.
And just a week.
And
yeah, it's crazy.
And we're seeing people bid over list price, just crazy things that we
wow.
have not seen in many, many years. So it,
yeah.
so it's great. I mean
and people are debating also still nationally that, you know, it's not a good time to sell, but they're seeing that the profits that they had back in the boom, they can't get now.
Right.
But if those people are selling their house to move on to something else, they're going to make it up on the purchase of a house that's got great interest rate and it's a, you know, good priced home at that point.
Yeah, wow.
So that's why
relative.
It's, and this area is so much better for that than anywhere else nationally.
Definitely. Okay, well listen, we are going to go to another break here. See, we're just flying through this interview. But listen, you can check out our breaking news tweets at SourceRadioNetW. Check us out on Twitter. See you when we get back.
Buying a home? Refinancing? With over 20 years' experience, Mark Ebinger of MNet Mortgage Corp has the right loan for you. Call Mark today to lock in a historically low mortgage rate. MNet Mortgage Corp is a direct lender and the key to your financing. Call Mark Ebinger today at 301-788-0996.
Mark Ebinger, NMLS 476332, MNet Mortgage Corp, NMLS 2688, Maryland Mortgage Lender License Number 19266, an equal opportunity lender.
In this challenging real estate market, you can't afford to leave the most important financial decision of your life to just anyone. Broker-owned and operated, Shank & Associates Realty provides quality real estate services and have the experience to easily exceed your expectations. Whether buying, selling, or managing property, let Rich Shank show you why he has been a consistent multi-million-dollar sales producer for over 12 years. Call Shank & Associates Realty today at 301-271-1122. Shank & Associates Realty is a proud sponsor of the champion Frederick Keys.
The Cozy Restaurant invites you Monday or Tuesday evenings for pasta night. That's right, create your own pasta dish from our pasta buffet. Or join us Wednesday and Thursday evenings for steak and grilled shrimp, along with my favorite all-you-can-eat crab legs. That's pasta night Monday and Tuesday, steak, grilled shrimp, and all-you-can-eat crab legs Wednesday and Thursday, 4 p.m. until closing, at the Cozy Restaurant, 80 years of fine dining traditions.
Okay, welcome back. This is Caressa Flannery. I am your hostess for the Rely Local Business Spotlight. And we are here talking real estate today with two folks from Long and Foster in the Frederick area. We have Sharon Bremer Potter and her husband, John Potter, who are a team of real estate professionals that deal with buyers and sellers and, you know, everything in between. And they even go beyond the sale and help with, you know, construction matters and things like that if necessary. But we were talking a little bit about, you know, real estate and, you know, people putting their houses on the market and getting them set and ready, you know, for that big process. And then, you know, what about some of those homeowners that are underwater on their mortgages and they need to sell their home? So how do you guys help them, you know, with what are some of the options out there for these folks, you know, who are struggling and, you know?
First of all, there's refinancing programs available for people that are, they haven't had a distress situation come up. And there's HARP 2.0. A lot of banks are refinancing, helping these people out because they really don't want the people to go into foreclosures.
They don't want those houses.
No, they don't. They have enough of them right now.
Yeah, they do.
It's supposed to be a shadow inventory coming out here anytime soon, but we haven't seen that yet. So,
right.
But they're really having these programs come out and help a lot. The HARP 2.0 is mainly for people that have the Freddie Mac and Fannie Mae insured loans. The ones that have conventional financing, there's other programs that are available. They just have to, you know, find somebody that has the resource like us to turn them on to the right people to get that accomplished.
Right. And you guys mentioned earlier that you do have the resources, you know, as far as lenders and things like that. So
absolutely. We have a great source of, we network a lot. So we know a lot of the local business owners and business people in the industry. And we have, you know, only the best of the best to refer to our clients. So they're in the best of hands possible. So absolutely. But
yeah, you guys are, I mean, you're pretty well known in the community as far as, you know, real estate goes. I mean, you know, I don't know if we term you top producers or whatever, but you definitely see you out there.
Sure, we do.
Oh, okay. Okay. Well, then you're top producers then. I don't know. I'm just the host here for the show. But no, I'm just saying that speaks volumes to a lot of people. You know, I mean, when you see, you know, people who are out there really doing it in the real estate industry, you want to work with these people because they have the contacts, they have the leads,
they have the know-how.
The know-how to get you through the process because
absolutely. This should be a good experience and it should be a fun process. It doesn't need to be stressful, you know.
Yeah,
and when you're in the right hands and somebody that knows knows.
Yeah, we take the stress for our clients.
Yes.
You know, we go in and try to remove that stress because we're there to help them. So it's like they can unburden some of that stress to us. Let us deal with it and we'll communicate and keep them up to breath on what they have to do constantly.
Yeah. Now, you know, I've purchased a home, only one, but I haven't, you know, been in the situation to be underwater or anything like that. But I hear this term short sale all the time.
Right.
So what exactly is a short sale? What does that mean? Like, you know, is that an option for, who is that an option for?
Well, it's when somebody owes more than what they need to pay off their mortgage, they're upside down.
What the value of their home is.
Right.
Basically.
So they couldn't sell it the traditional way and they need to sell their home for whatever. There's certain criteria that they need to meet to be able to short sale to where the bank will allow them to do so, which we are there to educate people if they, you know, we always interview our clients first that are in that situation or think they might potentially be a candidate. We have to interview them and go through the criteria to see if they fit, you know. And then it's just a process of negotiating with the bank. And John and I are certified. We both have, between the two of us, three certifications, different levels of courses that we have taken to educate ourselves on the short sale process, as well as we have done
the experience.
Many. The experience. Most importantly,
alone is,
beyond all the courses in the world that you can take, it's really the hands-on of having done it.
Does it happen quickly? I mean, because is it called short sale because it's short?
process?
No, it can. Well, I mean, it can be a long process. It depends on the bank you're dealing with and really the agent that you're dealing with and whether they know the process and how to get it done. Because there's a lot of work involved with getting them to closing and staying on top of it and making sure it gets there. But all of mine have closed within 4 months. I mean, they've gotten approval within three and closed within four. But I, you know, there is talk out there of people that have gone 6 to 8 months. But those, you know, my particular sellers and the people I've worked with on the selling end, maximum has been 4 months to get to closing.
And yeah, so, we go in and make sure that people are to understand that this process has to be done and done a specific order for the bank to even evaluate if they're eligible. So document collection is up to us. But the homeowner has to, when we ask for something, they have to give it up right away so we can get it to the bank.
Yeah.
So most of the time they go through though, right? They happen.
All of mine have gone through.
They just take longer.
It's just a process. And it's something that you have to stay on top. The agent involved has to stay on top of to get it through in a timely manner. Because
short sales have been around for a long time. It's just that it's become more prevalent because of, you know, the foreclosures. Now it's like, that's the way to go. Before, it would happen before, but just, it was a very small percentage. And now it's become... And it's because the short means the bank is accepting a short payment on that mortgage is what that is. That's why the term short sale is there. So
I'm an individual who's only purchased one home, so I haven't, you know, been in that process as many times as, you know, some other folks have. And you know, luckily I haven't had financial issues.
Absolutely.
People walk away from their homes.
I've stayed in my townhouse and not upgraded and gone beyond my means.
And people, you know, they give up sometimes and walk away from their homes, and they don't have to, you know, because that foreclosure is really hurts their credit and their ability to purchase later on anything, basically. So,
but a short sale doesn't. So
it doesn't hurt as bad.
Okay.
Right. And it depends
and
on how efficient we are getting it done.
Buy again in 3 years, 2 to 3 years, depending on their situation. So versus seven if they foreclose.
We're sad because people do that, and they had a hardship situation where it's perfectly acceptable to have it approved by the bank.
Right.
And it's a shame that they do that.
Yeah.
And
it's really
instead
just
of
a lack
calling
of
somebody like us to take care of it.
Yeah. Right. It's just a lack of the know-how of
it is.
Who to call.
Yeah.
Well, lack of information.
I have a big question here. Mm-hmm. Of course, we're changing the subject a little bit here, but you guys have this tagline, your American dream team. So tell me why you chose that and why is that, you know, important? I mean, what does that mean, basically?
Well, when we formed this team back in 08, I mean, the mortgage crisis was on and people were like, they don't want to own homes anymore. And we're like, no, you know, the American dream is still there, to own your own home. Mm-hmm. And now that we're coming out of it, even the government is using it in some of their things, that the dream of American home ownership is still there, and they want people to still have that. So I think it's great, and that's why we use that, and that's what we use in our website is Your American Dream Team.
That's right. Okay, well, we're getting ready to end here. Isn't that amazing?
Wow.
Like, our time is so short.
It is.
So
let's do this again.
I've had a blast. It's so much fun. So, okay. Big thing here, though. We want to make sure everybody out there listening knows how to get hold of Sharon and John. So tell us how they do that.
Sure. We can be reached 301-676-4031 is my number. And John,
my number is 301-471-9549. And our direct office line is 301-620-0066. And all this contact information is on our website, which is www.youramericandreamteam.com.
So it's youramericandreamteam.com. And then, of course, I know you guys are on Facebook, too, so if people want to connect with you there, I imagine you probably put things
out there.
And I know I've seen you out there everywhere. So, and that's a good thing. Definitely a good thing. All right. Well, folks, we are done with Sharon and John today. That's amazing. It just flew by. But stay tuned for our next program. The Bobby Likas Car Clinic is sponsored by Rely Local member Roddy Creek Automotive right here in Thurmont, Maryland. This is Caressa Flannery, your host for the Rely Local Business Spotlight. We will talk with you next time. Take it.
Thanks for tuning in to Rely Local Frederick's Business Radio Spotlight right here on AM 1450, The Source. Heard Saturdays at 1:30 p.m., Rely Local Frederick's Business Radio Spotlight is a movement, a campaign to take us back to what makes America great. Businesses locally owned and operated by you and your neighbors. Thanks for spending your valuable time today with us.